Connor buys a bag of cookies that contains 7 chocolate chip cookies, 5 peanut butter cookies, 7 sugar cookies, and 7 oatmeal cookies. What is the probability that Connor reaches in the bag and randomly selects an oatmeal cookie from the bag, eats it, then reaches back in the bag and randomly selects a peanut butter cookie? In this case, the event of selecting an oatmeal cookie and the event of selecting a peanut butter cookie are not independent events because the probability of selecting a peanut butter cookie is affected by first selecting an oatmeal cookie and not replacing it because Connor eats the cookie. So we have two dependent events that states if events A and B are not independent, then the probability of A and B equals the probability of A times the probability of B given that A has already occurred. So in our case, we're trying to find the probability that Connor first selects an oatmeal cookie, which we'll use O to represent oatmeal, eats it, and then goes back into the bag and selects a peanut butter cookie, which we'll use P for a peanut butter cookie. And again, these are not independent, so this is equal to the probability of selecting an oatmeal cookie times the probability of selecting a peanut butter cookie given an oatmeal cookie has already been selected. Let's begin by determining the total number of cookies. It would be 7 plus 5 plus 7 plus 7, which equals 26. So our probability, the probability of O and then P, is equal to the probability of selecting an oatmeal cookie. We'll notice how there are 7 oatmeal cookies out of the total of 26 cookies, and therefore the probability of selecting an oatmeal cookie would be 7/26 times, now here's where we have to be careful, the probability of selecting a peanut butter cookie given the oatmeal cookie has already been selected. Since Connor has already selected one cookie, there's no longer 26 cookies, there's now only 25. So the total number of outcomes would now be 25 of those 25 cookies. Notice 5 of them are peanut butter cookies. So the probability of selecting a peanut butter cookie, given an oatmeal cookie has already been selected, would be 5/25. Now before we multiply though, let's simplify. 5/25 does simplify. There's 1 5 and 5, and 5 5s and 25. So our product would be 7/26 times 1/5. Multiplying the numerators, we have 7. Multiplying the denominators, we have 130. So this would be the probability of selecting an oatmeal cookie, eating it, then going back into the bag and selecting a peanut butter cookie. But probability can also be expressed as a decimal and a percentage. So let's also find those. To convert the fraction to a decimal, we'll divide. We would have 7 divided by 130. Let's round to 4 decimal places, and therefore this is approximately 0.0538. Notice how the 4 indicates to round down. So this is also approximately 0.0538. Converting to a percentage, we would multiply by 100 and add a percent sign, which would be 5.38%. But we should keep in mind that the exact probability would be this fractional value, and these two are approximations. I hope you found this helpful.